This 13-metre-high pyramid installation titled Light Arts was situated in Melbourne's Federation Square. It was there for a month, concluding July the 3rd, 2011. Light Arts is part of the month-long Light in Winter Festival of Art and Performance at Federation Square. The festival's artistic director, Robin Archer, assigned the festival's theme for 2011 as that of fire. In 2010, the theme was the sun. Creator Bruce Ramis considered the Light Arts Pyramid as a unifying object for the festival. Ramis reportedly says that one inspiration was the etymology, not the only one, but that the word pyramid has meaning as measurement of fire or measurement of light. That seemed to resonate with this particular festival. Here are some further excerpts and quotes regarding Light Arts. Since Light Arts was unveiled last Thursday, members of the public have draped knitting and hung homemade lanterns on it, or just enjoyed hanging out in a novel setting. The idea is that as the month goes on, the pyramid will be further populated by community offerings, such as art or people's own lights, to create a giant light sculpture. It's starting to become a growing sort of living thing, says Ramis. Ramis goes on to say, my hope is that it, over the course of the month, provides a little bit of shelter and a bit more light to our lives, a bit more togetherness. A midwinter solstice celebration is held during the festival. In 2011, it was held on Saturday, the 18th of June. The actual 2011 solstice date was Wednesday, the 22nd of June. The Northern Hemisphere, where there are a few festivals of light, has the fabulous advantage that Christmas falls in winter, and they can have lovely Christmas lights. But in the Southern Hemisphere, we've got to have a different excuse, says Archer, the Light in Winter Festival Director. Under the program stream titled Gift of Light, the celebration of the midwinter solstice in 2011 included the lifting and procession of specifically 1,000 lanterns.
1,000 lanterns here at Fed Square, let me see you. Let's celebrate together as a family.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause!
Website My Society informs us that the lantern raising is part of the Night of 1,000 Lights. I have little doubt this is a reference to the 1,000 points of light dark occultist George H.W. Bush referred to at various moments within his public addresses.
The world can therefore seize this opportunity to fulfill the long-held promise of a new world order. We can find meaning and reward by serving some higher purpose than ourselves, a shining purpose, the illumination of 1,000 points of light.
I'm a man who sees life in terms of missions, missions defined and missions completed. I will not allow this country to be made weak again. I will keep America moving forward. Endless, enduring dream and 1,000 points of light. This is my mission, and I will complete it.
1,000 lanterns here at Fed Square. Let me see you. Let's celebrate together as a family.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause.
And 1,000 points of light.
The esoteric meaning of the phrase 1,000 points of light is likely to be dualistic. Alice A. Bailey makes numerous mention of a point of light within her volumes titled Discipleship in a New Age. In summary, some of the passages seem to explain that a point of light, indeed an advancing point of light, can be nurtured and expanded within the body's chakras. Interestingly, reference is made to a 1,000-petaled lotus found at the centre above the head. The design on the stonework of the St. John's College Gate depicts the triangle in between the eagle slash, perhaps phoenix's, head and the sun. The St. John's College building frontage depicts the triangle now upon, or perhaps in union, with the sun. What is perhaps represented here is a rising, triune, trinity-like status of human consciousness to meet and unify with the consciousness of the sun. Notice also how the eagle has the ubiquitous glowing circular region behind its head. The greatest gift of all. The King has returned on Christmas Day. Leo the Lion has a mane of sunrays and is a Northern Hemisphere summer constellation. Regalty also adorns those coronal rays. The bright star Regulus adorns the Leo constellation. This logo is perhaps a depiction of the left and right brain plus the Regulus star. In short, the keystone, according to Mark Passio, represents the pineal gland whilst not fully activated. Its removal, or pineal awakening, allows light to pour in and activate the union of the heart chakra. In the left image, we see angels unified, and in the right image, we see the heart at a similar elevation within the illustration to the angels. Here we see the lion and the crown upon the keystones. I wonder if this is perhaps a symbolic depiction of the alchemical transmutation of the keystone into a light portal. Notice the keystone-like shapes at the top of the heads. Please observe for interaction between humans and the sun. So we have briefly looked at the glowing circle shape, a shape of oneness, of perfection, of godliness, bathed in illuminating light. So now, let's have a look at the triangle. Depicted here is some of the meaning ascribed to the triangle, according to Mark Passio. Multiples upon multiples of occult meanings apply to the triangle. Bailey informs us of three triplicities, being of the personality, soul, and spirit. Let's delve further with Bailey's esoteric philosophy. Meditation, in its most rudimentary form, is the instinct which leads to recognition of the physical sun and governs, for instance, the turning of planetary vegetable life towards the sun as its dominant source of life. In its intermediate form, it is that which reveals to the aspirant and to the hierarchy the heart of the sun. And, in its highest form, it is the mode of contact which relates the highest beings on our planet to the central, spiritual sun. Bailey mentions hierarchy amongst souls numerous times. George H.W. Bush's inaugural address on January the 20th, 1989, alludes to hierarchy within the points of light, in my opinion. Here is a speech excerpt.
For not only leadership is passed from generation to generation, but so is stewardship. I've spoken of 1,000 points of light, of all the community organizations that are spread like stars throughout the nation doing good. We will work on this in the White House, in the cabinet agencies. I will go to the people and the programs that are the brighter points of light, and I'll ask every member of my government to become involved. The old ideas are new again because they're not old. They are timeless. Duty, sacrifice, commitment, and a patriotism that finds its expression in taking part and pitching in.
The many smaller lights below the larger light at the apex of the pyramid reminds me of these hierarchical notions. Indeed, the pyramid apex probably represents George H.W. Bush's higher purpose, that shining purpose.
Some higher purpose than ourselves. A shining purpose. The illumination of 1,000 points of light.
This higher purpose than ourselves, from which we can find meaning and reward, this shining purpose, of which George H.W. Bush seems to portray as the illumination of 1,000 points of light, really brings all but the highest of occultists, I'm sure, to a most mysterious esoteric juncture. At this point, I now find myself pondering the esoteric light bringer, Lucifer, and simply want to suggest to people to not get too caught up in the anthropomorphization of esoteric concepts alone, as this may draw attention away from our very selves and our part as frequency, perhaps in an allegorical 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle of light. Ocular, the eye, cult, Latin, cultus, care, cult, Greek, ritual, behavior, occult, hidden. Dark and light forces exist within the occult. Whilst dark forces may pervert various symbols for themselves, let them not sully our perspective, and may we gain knowledge and insight that emboldens our own lives and journeys for the better, for one and for all. In part 2, I will freeform a little as I attempt to cover a few more ideas. I hope you enjoyed the presentation thus far.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause!